TFNN. Headline news update.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN, 2 p.m. Eastern Time on Wednesday. It is Fed Day. We're going to get an announcement as we speak. Right now, markets in positive territory, quite a day ahead of the Fed announcement. We have a press conference as well. Chairman Powell, we'll see what he has to say. Right now, S&P is up 69 points, trading at 29.33. Got the Dow up 235, trading at 89.56. NASDAQ up 240, trading at 89.60, Dow up 505, 24,551, putting this on a little bit of a shorter term time frame. You see the volatility starting to come in the market in the S&Ps. We'll get the Fed decision in a moment. We'll start things off. We'll jump over to the charts and we'll start it off with the indices. And there we go. Dow 30, check out the run. We're above 24,600 in the last 45 minutes, currently trading 24,541. Been an upward trend for most of the day. Early, we were trading 24,182, now trading a solid 400 points above that level. S&Ps, 29.35. You back it up to where we started the week in terms of Sunday futures. We were almost 100 points lower, 28.20 Sunday night futures. Right now trading at 29.35. And as we get the news, I'm going to pull it over so we can see the headlines right here. You have the Fed pledging to keep rates near zero until full employment and inflation comes back. That is your headline. The market gonna like that. The market had an idea that might be happening. That's why you saw, I think, an acceleration even today ahead of that news. The Fed pledging to keep rates near zero until full employment. Federal Reserve painted a dour picture of the current conditions, pledged Wednesday to continue its historically aggressive policy stance until it's comfortable that the U.S. economy is back on its feet. Following this week's FOMC meeting, the central bank said it would maintain its current interest rate target between 0% and 1/4 percentage point basis points. The ongoing public health crisis will weigh heavily on economic activity, employment, and inflation in the near term and poses considerable risk to the economic outlook over the medium term, the committee said in its post-meeting statement. The committee expects to maintain this target range until it's confident that the economy has weathered recent events. Market liking that news, holding the gains up about 67 points. Don't forget, folks, Tom O'Brien, he's coming up at 4 o'clock, but tomorrow at 9 a.m., Timing the Trade webinar, all-day webinar on the front page at TFNN. Great time to check that out. Lots of earnings, folks. It's Fed Day. We got Facebook, Tesla, all that action after the bell. Stay tuned, folks. Dave White at 2, Tom O'Brien at 3. We'll be right back.